Let's see what is SR latch now. SR latch can be either implemented as a cross-coupled NOR gate or it could be implemented using cross-coupled NAND gates. First, let's explore how the SR latch will work as a memory unit with cross-coupled NOR gates. It has two external inputs, set, which is represented as S, and reset, represented as R. And there are two useful states for this SR latch. One is the set state, the other is the reset state. And we can observe the set state with Q is equal to 1. Is the set state, and Q bar normally will represent the complement of Q, and therefore this will become 0. And a reset state will make this Q equal to 0, and therefore the Q bar will become correspondingly 1. So these are the two useful states of this SR latch, and let's see how we are able to store this information. As we have a feedback path, let's assume that we have some value set to Q. Okay, let's assume that this Q is currently 1 and we are having the external input, say R is 1 and S is 0. Now let's see how this circuit behaves. When R is equal to 1, okay, this line is 1. And since we have Q is equal to 1, Q bar will be 0. Therefore, from this line, which is Q bar, we will get a 0 here. And similarly, this line is going to give 1 as input and set is coming as 0. So, since this is a NOR gate, which is AND followed by a, sorry, which is OR followed by a NOT operation, so 1 or 0 is 1 and NOT of 1 is 0. So what you are going to get here as output is 0. So initially it was 1, now this Q becomes 0. Okay, and similarly here if you see 1 and 0, it is going to give 0. So this input will remain as 0. Now this 0, which is Q, which changes from this 1 to 0, will be fed back here, and this 1 will now become 0, and now this will become 1. This 0 will go off and we will get 0 or 0 is 0 and NOT of 0 is 1, and this 1 will come here, and 1 or 1 is 1 and NOT of 1 is 0, and therefore this Q remains as 0. And now this has stabilized. So this 0 is coming as input, this is already 0, and this is 1, and this is 1. Okay. So now this is the reset state. Okay. We have reset equal to 1, and therefore we have made the state Q set to 0. This is the reset state. Suppose if we remove this input, when this value is reset, that is Q is 0, and suppose if we remove this external inputs, that is I change R from 1 to 0. Let's see what will happen to the signal here. I will erase this and let's see what will happen to the values that are present in the circuit. This line is 0, this line is going to be 1. Now this line is set to 0 instead of 1. Now 0 or 1 will give you 1 and NOT of 1 is 0, and this 0 will be supplied here. This is already 0, and therefore 0 or 0 is 0, not of 0 is going to be 1. You can see that even after we have removed this external input, the circuit still remain in the same state, which is the reset state. Okay, that is, the circuit is able to remember the value it was stored previously. That is how it behaves as a memory component. Now let's assume that we are setting the input S to 1. Assume that the previous state already stored in the circuit is 0, and now we are changing the input S to 1 and R remains as 0. In this case, what happens? So this is 0 or 1 is 1 and not of 1 is 0. And here now this input becomes 1. So 0 or 1 is 1, not of 1 is going to be 0 here. And this 0 will be supplied here, and 0 or 0 is 0, not of 0 is going to be 1. And this 1 is going to be supplied here, and 1 or 1 is 1, not of 1 is 0. So now the output stabilizes, that is Q bar is 0 and Q is 1. Okay, we have set the circuit, and therefore we are able to write the information 1 as the state of the circuit. Now suppose if we remove the input S, that is we are going to change this 1 to 0. In this case, what happens? This input has now become 0. So 0 or 1 is 1, not of 1 is 0, so this remains as 0. So 0 or 0 is 0, not of 0 is going to be 1. So the circuit still remembers this 1 even after you have removed this input 1. It is able to retain this information. And the circuit will behave in an unexpected way if we supply both R and S to be 1. And therefore this input is forbidden, but let's see why, how it behaves. Okay, although it is forbidden, it's nothing wrong to check what happens if the input is wrong. Okay, so I'm not supposed to give 1 and 1. Let's see what happens if we supply 1 and 1. So when let's clear all this thing and let me come back. So Q was set and Q dash was 0. Now we are setting the reset and set input as 1. Now this 1 will come here, this 0 will come here, and 0 or 1 is 1, not of 1 is going to be 0, and this 0 is going to come here, and 0 or 1 is 1, not of 1 is going to be 0, and this 0 will come here. So this behavior will be like, see, we know that Q and Q bar are complement to each other, but when we supply both R and S to be 1, both Q and Q dash become 0. Okay, so that is why this pair of inputs is forbidden. We are not allowed to give this input to the circuit. This is the function table of SR latch. You have input S and R, and output state is Q, and we have Q bar. If we know Q, we can observe Q bar as well. So when we set the circuit, when S is equal to 1, okay, and reset is 0, Q will become 1, and therefore Q bar is 0. When we remove the input S, okay, this is the input to retain the information of the circuit. Therefore, there will not be any change in the output of the circuit or any change in the state of the circuit. And the output of the circuit or the state of the circuit depends on the previous state. What state the circuit was before we remove the input. And when we reset the information, Q will be reset and Q bar will be 1. And if we remove the information, that is when we supply 0 and 0 after S was 0 and R was 1. That is, this was the previous state. We are resetting the circuit. That means that the information will be retained. There will not be any change in the state of the circuit. And 1, 1, we have seen that this will produce 0 and 0 as output, and therefore it is forbidden.